At the 50th anniversary of the International Capital Market Association, we mark 5 decades of individuals working together across national borders to support the development of the world's largest market for international capital. A market which has played a pivotal role in funding unprecedented economic growth over the past 50 years.
Economic developments in this world, the world we live in today, would not have been possible without the rapid and international development of our capital market.
Ever since the ICMA was founded 50 years ago, it has played a very important role in bringing together the different market participants around one table.
I think that without the International Capital Market Association, we would not be possible to run the global markets as they are.
Just 19 firms formed the association 50 years ago to work out the rules around trading and settlement in the new Eurobond market. From this, ICMA has grown to over 530 member firms in 62 countries and involves more than 2,000 individuals from its membership. It represents the views of all users of the market. This collective industry endeavour has driven forward the development of cross-border capital markets both in Europe and globally.
It's about the marketplace, it's about funding the economy, and it's about making sure that all parties are protected and supported during the process.
ICMA is a great example of how the industry works together.
ICMA has played a key role in bridging China and the international capital market.
Innovating to meet the changing needs of the economy with increasing focus on environmental and social benefits.
I think green bonds' future is only one of growth. We can see this because investors tell us that it is their largest growing area of assets under management. ICMA has drawn global attention to the topic and has really worked with each and every region around the world.
There is further potential for the capital markets to play an even greater role. They continue to evolve against a backdrop of changing regulatory environment, rapid technological innovation, and political headwinds, which have increased the risks of market fragmentation.
There is a big debate about whether globalization is going to be rolled back. I think there are arguments in, for example, global trade, saying that, yes, we will see some reversal in globalization.
It's quite difficult to predict how the role of the buy side will change in the future, because much depends on the shape of regulations as well as the sort of competitive landscape.
I think this is a fascinating time to be in capital markets. FinTech and the years ahead will bring us a huge amount of change that I think we can take as an opportunity.
The industry needs to continue working together to shape the capital markets of the next 5 decades, ensuring that they continue to bring benefits to the future citizens of the world and enabling new regions to become fully engaged. It must embrace the experience of a diverse, highly skilled workforce and bring in fresh ideas from future leaders of the capital markets.
I certainly see that the banks in the industry are striving to try to incorporate more diversity. Bringing diverse perspectives to an issue helps you to achieve a more thoughtful outcome.
The original founders of ICMA were pioneers under 30. I believe the current generation also has the potential to come up with groundbreaking ideas and, let's say, set the tone for the years to come.
The marketplace of the future will be very different from the marketplace of the past, but the guidance we give will hopefully help all our membership and all practitioners understand how the markets work and get it to function as best as it can.
As we celebrate 50 years, we thank all our members and partners whose support has made ICMA's work on the development of the international capital markets possible. Welcome to the 50th ICMA Annual General Meeting and Conference.